Hello everyone. This is the first lecture on fixed point theory.
Today I am going to explain what is metric space and its related examples, some more definitions related to metric space, contraction mapping, fixed point and graphical representation of fixed point.
Now what do you mean by a metric space? Let X be any non-empty set. A mapping D going from X cross X to R, where this R is a set of real numbers, is said to be metric or distance function if and only if D satisfy the following axioms. Now what are these axioms? The first one, the distance between two points is always greater than or equals to 0. That means distance of XY, it is greater than or equal to 0 for all XY belonging to the set X. The second point is distance of x comma y is 0 if and only if x is equal to y. Number 3, the distance of xy is same as the distance of yx, means it is symmetric. Whatever the points, the distance going from x to y or going from y to x, both are same. The fourth one, distance of xy is less than or equal to distance of xz plus distance of zy. This is true for every x, y, z belonging to the set X. And this property is called Rangel's inequality, means the distance between the two sides, the sum of the two sides is always greater than or equal to the third side. So this is called Rangel's inequality. So if D, which is any mapping defined on this set, then if it satisfies all these four properties, then this D is said to be the metric for the set X. And the ordered pair x comma d is called a metric space, and dxy is called the distance between x and y. Now see the examples. Now the first example, let's suppose our x is the set of real numbers, means line R. Then the usual distance, which is nothing but the mod of x minus y, it satisfies all the four properties. And this is called usual distance, right? So this is metric defined on the set of R. Similarly, on the set R square, the distance is denoted by this. Take the x1 minus x2 whole square plus y1 minus y2 whole square, square root. So this is the two metric. Sometimes this is called two metric. Also, let x to be any set, the discrete metric on the set X is given by whenever the points are same, the distance is 0. The points are different, the distance is 1. This D is said to be the discrete metric on the set X. So this defines a metric on the set X in which no distinct pair of points are close. So now some more definitions. First of all, what do you mean by the diameter of the set A? So let XD be a metric space and A be any non-empty subset of X. Non-empty means A set having at least one element. So then the diameter of A, which is denoted by this symbol, is defined by, you first of all find out the distances between the all points of the set A. Then from all these distances, the supremum will represent the diameter of the set A. So the supremum of all the distances between the points of set A is the diameter of the set A, and it is denoted by this symbol delta of A. Now the distance between the point and a set. So for this we consider any point of the set X and any subset of metric space X. Now the distance between P and A is nothing. You first find out the distance between the P and every point of A, right? You consider every point of A, find out all these distances. The infimum of the least value of the distance will represent the distance between the point P and the set A. And if this distance is 0, it means your P is the member of A. P belongs to the member, belongs to the set A. The next is the distance between two non-empty sets. So let A and B, they are any two non-empty subsets of metric space X. Then distance between this is denoted by D of A comma B, and this is what you find out all the distances by considering X from the set A and y from the set B, find out all these distances and then find out the minimum distance from this set. That represents the distance between the two sets A and B. The next is the definition of interior point. Let XD be a metric space, AB any subset of X. A point X from the set X is said to be interior of A if there exist R greater than 0. We consider an open sphere around the set X. Okay. If this open sphere, this neighborhood is completely contained in the set A, then this point of set X is said to be an interior point of A. It means this point completely lies inside the set A. So this is an interior point of A. What do you mean by exterior point? Again, we consider an open sphere. If this open sphere around the point X is completely lying in A complement, or you can say its intersection with the set A is phi, then this point is an exterior point of A. Okay, so what do you mean by boundary point of A? If X is neither an interior point of A nor an exterior point of A, then this X is said to be the boundary point of A, and it is denoted by delta A. So the boundary point of A, this set is denoted by this symbol, right? So means, what do you mean by boundary point of A? If this point is neither an interior, means we find out an open sphere around the point X. If it's not completely contained in A, similarly it is not completely contained in A complement, then this X is lying at the boundary of the set A. Now what do you mean by convergence? You are given a sequence in a metric space X. Let's suppose x1, x2, x3 till up to xn. This be any sequence in a metric space X. Then this sequence is said to be converged to X if you find out the limit n going to infinity if xn is X. Then we say this sequence xn converging to X. Now what do you mean by Cauchy sequence? Let Xd be a metric space, Pn be any sequence of points in the set X. Then this Pn is said to be Cauchy if and only if for every epsilon greater than 0, there exists positive integer n epsilon such that for every m n greater than or equal to this n, this implies the distance between Pm and Pn, both these are less than epsilon. Means after leaving some finite numbers, the distance between every two points is less than epsilon. Then we say this sequence is a Cauchy sequence. So it is clear that every convergent sequence is Cauchy, but converse need not be true. So for this we can define a complete metric space. So what do you mean by complete metric space? A metric space XD, it is said to be complete if and only if every Cauchy sequence in X converges to a point in X. Now the next, let's suppose T be any self-mapping. Self-mapping means T is going from X to X, right? Then this self-mapping is said to be Lipschian if for all X, Y belonging to the set X and for any alpha greater than equals to 0, this thing holds. This means what? The distance of Tx, Ty, if it is less than equal to alpha, distance of XY for every XY belonging to the set X, right? Then this self-mapping T defined on a set X is said to be Lipschian, right? Then this mapping T is said to be contraction if this alpha belongs to 0, 1, open from 1 and close from 0. Then this T is said to be contraction. So there is a condition on alpha. If our alpha belongs to semi-open, semi-close set, close from 0 but not including 1, if for this alpha our T mapping satisfying this inequality, then the self-mapping T is said to be contraction. If this alpha is exactly 1, then this is called non-expensive, right? So now just see, what do you mean by contraction? Basically, contraction mein kya ho raha hai? You consider any two points from the set X, you find out the distance, okay? And when you apply this mapping, you get Tx, Ty, these are also the points of the set X. And now you find out the distance. This distance is very, very small, means contracting. Here the distance between two points is large. But here in Tx, in T mapping, the distance between two points is very, very small. So these are contracting here. So this type of mapping is called contraction mapping. And contraction mapping is always continuous. We will prove it later on. So now the example, next is the definition of fixed point. Let XD be a matrix space and T be any mapping, any self mapping. Then the point X from the set X is said to be the fixed point of T if X is mapped to itself. If X is mapped to itself means what? Tx is same as that X. Then this X is said to be the fixed point of T. For example, if we consider T to be a mapping from set of real numbers to set of real number defined by T of X is equal to X by 2, right? Then clearly 0. If we put X to be 0, you get this is equal to 0. So T of 0 is 0. So T of X is X. So 0 is the fixed point of this mapping. Similarly, if we consider Tx as x square, then we find out those points from the set R such that Tx is equal to x. So now just see, when you put x to be 0, you get T of 0 is 0. And when you put 1, x to be 1, you get again it is T of 1 is 1. So these are two fixed points of T. Similarly, if we consider T to be a mapping going from R square to R square defined by T of X, Y is equal to X, then this has infinitely many fixed points. All the points which are lying on X axis, they are the fixed points. Right? Now just see how this mapping is defined like this. The T of X, Y is X. So now you put Y to be any number, you put X to be any number and Y to be any number. Let's suppose I put X to be 1 and Y to be 2. It is always 1. Okay. So whatever the X, whatever the Y, it is this T of X, Y is always X. So, if you vary all these X, you will always have this X. It doesn't depend on Y. So, it always depending on the first, that means on the X axis. So, all the points lying on the X axis, they will become the fixed points of this mapping. Right? So, this mapping have infinitely many fixed points. So, now we can easily see there exist some mappings which have unique fixed point, which have finite fixed points, which have infinitely many fixed points. So there may exist mappings which have no fixed points. So now graphically fixed points are exactly those points where the graph of the function f, whose equation is y is equal to fx, crosses the diagonal whose equation is y is equal to x. Right? Means what? Fx is equal to x means what? You draw the graph of fx, you draw the graph of x, the points where this y is equal to fx cut the x axis, these points are called the fixed points of this fx. Okay? For example, if you consider fx to be x cube plus 4x square minus 3x minus 16, then you from this graph, we can easily see x is equal to 2, x is equal to 2, minus 2, minus 4. These are the fixed points of this fx because they lie on the line y is equal to x. Now the remark, there may exist such mappings which have no fixed points. For example, if we consider x to be any non-empty set and we define a mapping t going from x to x by a translation mapping x plus a, tx is equal to x plus a. Here a is any constant, then clearly this mapping has no fixed point. This mapping has no fixed point. This mapping has no fixed point. Now why? Now just see what is, by the definition of fixed point, we want all those x belonging to the capital X so that t of x is equal to x. So x plus a is equal to x. Your xx will be cancelled out. You left a with 0. But here a is any known 0 constant. Right? So we will not find any value of x. We satisfy this. So clearly translation mapping, only translation mapping, they have no fixed point. So this mapping have no fixed point. Another way to say that this mapping have no fixed point is graphically, since the graph of x plus a is shifted from the center. Okay, what will be the graph of x plus a? This is a line which not passes through 0 0. However, y is equal to x is a line which passes through 0 0. Both these lines are parallel to each other, they never cut each other. So that means this t mapping have no fixed point.